The seafood industry is one of the last in the world that feeds millions of people by relying on the productivity of the natural environment. In Alaska, the effort to maintain healthy oceans and sustainable fisheries is never ending. In these pristine waters, collaboration between fishermen, scientists, environmentalists, and regulators has resulted in dramatic advances in both fisheries and ecosystem management.
My name is Merrick Burden. I'm the Executive Director of the Marine Conservation Alliance. Bycatch, in my mind, is the intersection of several different things. We have social and economic issues. We have basically allocative issues, which are related to that. And at times we have a conservation issue. All of those things matter a great deal.
For the last several years, fishermen, scientists, fishing cooperative managers, net manufacturers, and some environmental groups have worked together to better understand fish behavior and to develop new trawl gear that reduces both bycatch and impacts on the seafloor. These projects often start by testing scale models of a new net design in flume tanks. Flume tanks are similar to wind tunnels, except a flume tank pumps millions of gallons of water instead of air. When it appears that a potential advancement to the gear has been achieved, the fishing industry seeks federal approval to conduct open water ocean trials in the Bering Sea and North Pacific.
We have several members who are developing and pioneering some of the most advanced fishing gear I think some of the world has ever seen that uses a lot of combinations of how species behave when they encounter fishing gear, looks at fluid dynamics and how water flows through nets, uses a lot of different engineering and biological factors that fishing gear can be designed around to influence bycatch.
You know, as a conservation organization coming in, we were really welcomed by each of these groups to come in and understand that this was a real conservation effort that there was going on and a way to really benefit the ecosystem and still allow these fishermen to be able to catch their fish.
So far, this collaboration has resulted in a significant decrease in halibut and salmon bycatch. In the Bering Sea pollock fisheries, new gear innovations appear to allow up to 40% of Chinook to actually swim back out of the fishing nets and continue on their journey. In the North Pacific, new gear innovations appear to allow 45% to 60% of the halibut that are encountered to also escape the nets. In these pristine waters, collaboration between fishermen, scientists, environmentalists, and regulators has resulted in dramatic advances in fishing gear technology, which have led to a reduction in bycatch and a reduction in impacts to marine habitat. Want to learn more about sustainable fishing practices and how Alaska's fishing industry is working to reduce bycatch and other ecosystem impacts? Please visit our website, YouTube channel, or Facebook page. It matters.